Hello YouTubers, welcome back to GQ Auto Diagnostics and Repair, where my job is to save you money. This evening I'm working on a 95 Toyota Corolla 1.8 stick shift 5-speed manual transmission. Customer complained that the vehicle was overheating, so the radiator was replaced a few months back. New radiator cap, new upper and lower radiator hoses. That was fine. Okay, coolant was low, so they needed to be adding coolant. So a couple things, I pressure out the system. I didn't see no leaks. So I started the vehicle, let it run, get to operating temperature. The temperature started to climb a little bit. Okay, so what I did, I turned the AC on to make sure that the fan's gonna come on, okay, and cool down the engine. And indeed, they did not. This fan, the condenser fan, the one that goes in front of the radiator, this on the front of the condenser, on this vehicle, is not good. It's not spinning at all. Okay, so the center, it got, you know, came apart from the blade. So that's quite common in this vehicle. I've seen several on my experience. Now this one didn't come on, so I have to hit it on the electrical motor on the body, then it starts spinning. So with that telling me, okay, the two fans are not good, radiator fan, that's not good, that's why the vehicle is overheating and it is puking the coolant, and that's why we need to be adding it. The engine seems to be running good at this point, so the vehicle is cold now. So we can open the radiator, make sure before you do anything, you never open the radiator cap if the vehicle is hot, okay? You don't want to burn yourself. Remember that part, okay? So we have full coolant. So what we're gonna do here, right there on the bottom, it is the drain, so we're gonna open it. Okay, let me try my other hand. There it is. And we're gonna drain some of the coolant here. So that way the coolant level goes down here. And we can remove the hose because we have to remove the fan. But we don't have enough room to pull it because of that. Just remember that part. Okay, so let me place the camera in an area that you guys can see, because it would be nice to see, like in one of the movies. So we're gonna wait for the coolant level, instead of being here, it goes down, so we can see the inside of the radiator. For this job, you guys are gonna need a 8mm or flathead screwdriver. A 10mm socket. I'm gonna be using this 1/4 inch. Seems like that's enough. So I'm gonna close the drain. Tight. Now we can That's it. Okay. It's gonna go there. We can lift. reservoir here. Put it over here, so keep it making a mess. Now we're doing a 10 millimeter. Let's see. This too, at the stem, it's a 10 millimeter. We're gonna put them here. Now on the bottom, I believe we have one bolt. Remove this. Remove the connector. I'm gonna squeeze it. Let me see. This one. Nope. That one. That's for something else. One, two. Can't show you the ones on the bottom because it's a hard place to get to, and it's kind of dark, so the camera is not gonna see it. But believe me, it's there. Right there. This one is right here by the. With the engine mount. Right there. All the stem length, which is great. Take all the gears away. Nice. Now we're gonna move it a little bit to the side because right here between the radiator, the battery. So you press the tab right next to it here. Hopefully you guys can see it. Just kind of dark. That tab. You either press and pull, and that part is done. Now we're gonna move this here, and this should come out. Be careful, so that way things they don't get broken. So. Have it. Okay. It's done. Here are the radiator fan assembly that we're gonna be using. Quick disclaimer once more. I am not sponsored by Duralast. I'll be nice, but not yet. Oh, AutoZone. Okay, I just wanna, again, thanks my friends from AutoZone for bringing the parts to me and helping me out every time they can. It's always appreciated, guys. I cannot thank you enough, and I hope all the other repair shops that let you know, how valuable you guys are for our business, the technician business. So thank you. Appreciate it, Hector, and Les, and Jeff, and everybody there right now. Look at this, nice and tagged. Excellent. What we're gonna do here, we're gonna open it up, make sure this part, it is the sim. So we have the two bottom here, they're separate, the two on the top, they're very close together. So far it kind of looks like we got the right part, so we're gonna find that out. Hopefully we can help this customer to save some money. You guys spin it, even if it's new, sometimes it can be uneven and I can hit the shroud and and things like that. All right, so the two areas where the bolts go, they're very narrow compared to the bottom. That's going to the top. The more wide area is gonna go on the bottom. And you get the idea. Now, once again, if you stay here with me this far, I wanna thank you for being here. Really appreciate it. And if you haven't done it already, please take a moment, subscribe to the channel, like the video, leave your comments so I can respond to your comments if I need to, or answer any question. What I'm gonna do here really quick, I'm gonna make sure the bottom clamp, hose clamp, is nice and tight. Okay, I just wanna make sure I don't overlook anything. Hold on. I make sure this is nice and yeah, feels pretty tight. Okay, that's that. Now we can put it on. You know, the bottom doesn't have enough room. Okay, so I added the coolant, installed the radiator cap, I added a little bit of coolant to the overflow tank. So now what we're gonna do, we're gonna test this. So I'm gonna go inside the vehicle, I'm gonna start the vehicle, and I'm gonna turn the AC on, and with the AC on, that fan should start working right away. The fan and the condenser fan, when they're working and the system is good, electrical, everything, it should start working right away. So that way, keep the condenser from overheating. Other way, we will need to wait for the vehicle to get to operating temperature, and that takes a little bit of time, and I don't want to make the video super long. Okay, so we just testing that fan is going to turn on when I put the AC on. Okay. You replace the radiator fan on a 95 Toyota Corolla without making a lot of mess with the coolant. So I hope you liked the video. If you did and you learned anything, if you got something from it, please take a moment, subscribe to the channel, like the video, share the video, and as usual, you know, God bless, do your best, forget the rest, and I will see you in the next video. Later.